back, and we're ready for part one of the Jungle Gym Funny Car build. I decided to go ahead and do the body work and paint the car body this time around. I generally don't like to do that because when I do my mock-ups or whatever, you handle the body a lot, and I don't like to, especially with enamel paint, even after 3 or 4 days, even mixing with lacquer thinner, that enamel can still be a little bit soft to the touch. If you handle it a whole lot, the body heat from your hands can soften it up. And I've left fingerprints in it before. And I generally, after it's set for maybe even a week or so, I still wear latex gloves or vinyl gloves or whatever. But I want to go ahead this time and do it because we're going to have to do some work, some body work. And we're going to have to do a little filling because this nose and tail, now we've already mounted the, and first of all, let me say that this video may be a little bit long because we're going to do a little tutorial. We're going to kill two birds with one rock here. We're going to do a little tutorial, and we're also going to talk about the body work that we're going to have to do. I have the nose and tailpiece mounted. Now, this car did not come as one piece, which I wish it had of, and I've never understood any of the manufacturers' thinking behind doing a funny car, especially a one from the early 70s on, why you would not do a one-piece body, since that's the way they were in real life. They were funny cars with one-piece bodies, at least the ones from after the late 60s on, even before they started extending the noses on the funny cars. The bodies, a lot of the front parts were fiberglass, and so the front fender and bumper and all that was just a facade. And and certainly by the 70s, funny cars didn't have bumpers. I mean, it was just, one big giant glob of fiberglass with molded in, the bumpers molded and painted up to look aluminum. But, and same with the grills and the lights and all that. There was no taillights on a funny car or headlights either. So, but anyway, this one came with the nose piece and this bumper and tail piece with the rear tail lights and chute mount and all separate. And they both fit terribly. They did not fit at all, even close to being correct. So it was one of those cases where if you got it perfect on one side, the other side had a huge gap. If you got it perfect on both sides, then the middle had a huge gap, and the same with the rear as well. So what I opted to do was just get it overall as good as I could get it. Not try to get any of it perfect, but try to get it as close to being overall acceptable, and then we'll come back and we'll do some filling. Now, the tutorial part that I wanted to do for you is going to be the use of Sprue glue, which if you're new to modeling, Sprue glue is simply Sprue pieces of plastic that the trees that your parts come on, and when you get through with the kit or as you go, you cut it up into small pieces. And what I do is I keep a bottle of, I'll just use this one, usually I keep a bottle of Tamiya, you can use testers, but Tamiya extra thin cement. And then as I go, when I get a new bottle, I'll dump half of it out into one of these bottles I'm already using, and I'll start to add Sprue as I go from one kit to another. And over time, it melts and it turns into liquid plastic. Now, the trick to it is get it the right consistency, because if you get it too thin, it will never set up, and then when you go to try to put it in a spot like, say, across this hood and in between the hood and the bumper, I don't know if you can see that, but you see we have a little groove in there where in real life this body would have been completely one piece and there would be no seams. And you don't want any seams or as seamless as you possibly can get it. But if you put your sprue glue too thin, then what it would do, it would just run through and come out the other side and it would never set up. If you get it too thick, then what it does is when you pull your brush or whatever you apply it with, strings will pull away from it and like when you use the old tube glue and you dip a toothpick in it when you pull it or whatever you apply it with, as you draw it away, those glue hairs, pull away and then they fall just at the most inopportune place, like on your painted body or whatever, some part that you don't want it on. But anyway, the rear I've already done some work on with the sprue glue. And what I did was I came in and I'm gonna try to, now this is my tablet, so we're gonna hope for the best as far as focus and what have you. Up in here where this tailpiece meets, there was quite a gap, and in this one corner back here, I put some flat stock in and then soaked it with Tamiya extra thin and let it set. And then once I got it in there, I come back with my sprue glue and closed that gap up some. And now we just went all the way across the seam where the bumper, or I'll say bumper, this bumper piece meets the body. All the way around. Now, what that did was it actually came through on this side and started, I don't know if you can see it or not, it started filling in this seam right here. Now, this other side wasn't nearly as bad, so as it came through, it pretty much sealed it up. Now, we don't want to get rid of this. We don't want to get rid of this body line because this was actually part of the body. This is what There was, you know, this was the top of, you know, an actual Vega. Well, this was the top of the tailpiece. Now, what they did was before they made the fiberglass body, is they mounted this wing, this little tailpiece on, and then made their fiberglass. And it looks like a separate piece, although it's all one piece. So. And we've got some work to do right here. I already came on the outside and touched up a little, but what we want to do is we want to come into that little cubby hole right there and fill that in. And the same way right here, we don't want to lose this wing definition, but we want to lose part of that divot where that sprue glue has settled into that spot. Now, the thing about sprue glue is once you if you when you start to make your foundation, you want to let that settle and settle in it as far as it's going to go, because you don't want to keep adding to it, because the weight of the glue will just keep pushing it, and you eventually you'll just you'll be running glue all out the bottom of the car or the other side or whatever. So we're going to let that sit for another day before we do any more to it, and then we'll come back in and touch up across here. But I wanted to go ahead and show you what we're going to have to do here. We're going to have to, as I showed you on this seam across the front here, we're going to have to seal that up, and we're going to have to come across, and we got it. The bumpers have a spot on the corners to fit into on the body molding. That was my guide of where to try to work from on both sides. The bumper fits over a little spot there. I don't know if you can see it. And so that was my guide. And then once I got my glue seam started, I kept it held in place. And then once that held up, then we started adding some glue around here to soften those edges up and then squeeze that together. And we've sanded just a little bit. Now we've still got seams we want to get rid of behind that headlight. What would be the headlight bezel on both sides, and then across this seam. And I'm going to show you kind of how to do that. As I said, this is going to be a long video, so bear with me. And as I'm applying this, we'll listen to a little music or something, maybe. I'm going to show you the consistency of the sprue glue that I like to have. It's kind of a cross between not too thick, but not too thin either. So And I like the applicator that comes with the Tamiya glue because it's small enough you can get into tight spots, but not so small that it won't pick up enough, glue to work with. Now, be prepared for it to stick all to the shaft of the applicator. So I don't know if you can tell, but if you see it dripping like that, once you run all the excess off the applicator and you run it off the end of the brush and you pull away, once you see that it's not going to pull any hairs away, that's about the way you want it. So in other words, when you pull away, you want it to break loose clean. And then same way, each time you do it, break away clean. If you pull it a little bit's okay, like that, and then it breaks, then you're good to go. Now if you pull it way up here and it's still attached to one of those hairs, then that's not any good because what's going to happen is when you do get it to break loose, one of those glue hairs, which is nothing but a real fine strand of liquid cement and plastic, is going to fall on your body and you're never going to get it off. I mean, not all the way. And it's going to leave that, as soon as that glue hits that plastic, it attacks it and it's going to leave a mark and you're going to be, you're going to have to go in there and sand and then smooth it back out and start all over again. So, but that's what we're going to do. And let's get started so we're not too long on this. What we're going to do first, I want to show you, and I'm going to try to work as close to this tablet as I can without making too big a mess and still accomplish what I'm going to try to get done here. And so we're going to come in, we're going to get started, and we'll let you listen to some music while I do this. All right, there you go. We got one side just a little heavier than the other side. I didn't want to mess with it. It was flowing out and coming off pretty good. I didn't want to break my momentum. Don't worry about that. We'll let this sit. Now, what we're going to do is we'll let this sit for probably, I'll probably let it sit for a week. I don't get up here much during the week, work week, just because of work, and I'm not home. There's not much daylight left, and I'm up at usually 3:30, quarter to 4 every day, so I've got about a 40-mile drive to work one way. So at any rate, we'll let that sit probably for a week, and especially a place where you have, a fairly thick area of it. It's just like filler, just regular Bondo or anything else used for filler. You want to let it sit and dry, and where you can come in and really sand, well. And let me see. I don't know if I got that as well. I'll tell you what. I'm going to come back in there just for a second and put just a little more in that one spot right there on the hood. I didn't get just as much as I wanted to right there. I'm going to try to get it in there without making too big a mess. Like I said, you have to... You really have to know this stuff. Now, if you do happen to use this and you do happen to get a little glue hair here or there, don't sweat it. Just let it sit. You're better off actually leaving it alone. If you get a big drop, or let's say a big thick hair drops off on your body or whatever, you're better off just leave it alone, because you go to try to wipe it, then you just make a mess. It just, wherever you wipe it, it attacks that area of the plastic, and you wind up with a mess. So we'll come back in a week after we've let it sit good, and we'll sand all this up, and for all practical purposes, you won't be able to tell once you smooth this out and come back and sand, get all, go all the way up to maybe about 6,000 grit, you won't be able to see any seams. It'll look like a one-piece body. Now, what I did, the reason why I went kind of heavy up here is the backside of those headlight bezels actually needed, they were above the body part of the hood, the actual body, so the front part of the fender. So what I tried to do is build that up some behind that, so when we go to sand, we still have, it'll still be even with the headlight bezel. The headlight bezel's not sticking up, at least not too much anyway. So, all right, there's where we're at with that. We'll let that sit. Hopefully we'll, in a week or so, or maybe 4 or 5 days, we'll come back and take a look at it, and we'll sand it. I probably won't sand it on camera, but I will sand it and show it to you when we get, once we get through, and let you take a look at it. All right. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this, and I hope you get something out of that. Sprue glue can be used in a lot of places where you don't want to, Bondo is a little hard to get into, and that some of the other fillers are not practical to use. So, all right, that's all for now. Take care of one another. Don't take any crap from anyone.